Let's see LCR series resonance circuit. What is resonance? You know, you have studied in 11th very well. Now, what is LCR series resonance circuit? When LCR series circuit admits maximum current, a circuit is said to be so when LCR series circuit admits maximum current, a circuit is said to be at resonance. Now for admitting current as maximum, for maximizing current, impedance of the circuit should be minimum. Now impedance of LCR circuit, you know, is equal to what? Z is equal to square root R square plus XL minus XC. So now the question arises, how can I minimize the impedance of the circuit by using frequency of AC source? So when we look at this issue, R is independent of the frequency. It has no dependence on the frequency. Only two factors, XL and XC, are depending on frequency. And XL is equal to omega L, that is 2 pi nu L, and XC is equal to 1 over omega C, that is 1 over 2 pi nu C. XL varies directly to the frequency and XC is varying inversely proportional to the frequency. So when you increase frequency, when nu increases, XL increases. And XC decreases. Similarly, when nu is decreased, XL decreases and XC increases. It means we can choose some intermediate frequency at which XL is equal to XC. So the condition for resonance is XL must be equal to XC. XL is equal to omega R, that is equal to omega R into L. I put omega R suffix here because for resonance. And XC you can write it as omega RC. So omega R resonance frequency is 1 over square root LC. Now since omega R is 2 pi nu R, so equal to 1 over square root LC, so resonant frequency is equal to 1 over 2 pi square root LC. This is called resonant frequency. Right? That's how you can calculate resonant frequency of this. As far as questions of frequency or resonance circuit as well as LCR series circuit looks identical, similar data is provided. But you can identify with few things. Now see, number one, properties of resonance circuit. Number one, circuit admits maximum current. Number two, your Z is equal to, Z has become equal to R. because XL is equal to XC, so Z is equal to R. Circuit becomes purely resistive. What are the properties of the purely resistive circuit? That applied EMF and current are in same phase. So third condition you can put it, applied EMF and current are in same phase. And one more condition you can deduce easily, since XL is equal to XC, this is the condition for series resonant circuit, and in series current flowing through the circuit is same. So if we multiply I on both the sides of this, see here, I here, I here, this becomes VL, this becomes VC. So at resonance, potential difference across inductor is equal to potential difference across capacitor. This is another important condition. So I told you four different conditions to identify or differentiate between normal LCR series circuit and LCR series resonance circuit. Now, what is the utility of LCR series circuit or understanding the series circuit and resonance? You will be surprised to know that so many electronic devices which you are using right now, like mobile, watching TVs, right? Mobile phones, internet connections, accessing your mails, accessing videos, these all are based on resonance. If resonance suddenly disappears, then probably you feel people are handicapped in a present time. You see, when the video is the internet connection is reduced in J&K, Jammu and Kashmir, from 4G to 2G, people are facing so much problem because so many things they cannot access. Now, for a resonant circuit, there is one very important characteristics which we have to study. What is that? Q factor. This is basically quality factor. What it does? What it does? It measures the sharpness of tuning. At resonance, how good quality factor of your device is? A few years back, there was a radio where we had to tune a radio station, and there was a tuner which we normally used to rotate, and eventually the needle moving on horizontal scale on the radio meets with the required value, say 104 fever, then it starts receiving signal. Unless the frequency of your set is equal to the frequency of signal which is transmitted, matches, or both the sets come into resonance, you cannot receive signal. That's what is resonance is doing, and that's what quality factor means. how sharply you match in a such a small range or as much as a small range around the marked point you can receive the signal, then quality factor is brilliant. I mean to say, in a radio set scale, suppose 98.3 is marked here, while you are moving needle and your needle exactly coincides here and you start receiving this channel, then quality factor is best. And if in your set you keep on receiving channel within this range, even then it is very good. But if you are receiving same channel within this range, you have quality factor of LCR circuit of device or instrument is best. Right? You cannot access over entire scale the same channel. That's what actually quality factor is doing. Have you ever thought that in this atmosphere there is a transmission by 93.5, 94 or say 98.3, 104, 104.5, so many channels I can't remember again. All signals which are transmitted, these respective transmitting stations are available in the air. When you want to listen a particular radio or FM channel, why didn't you tune with some other? I mean to say, while you are trying to listen 98.3, then why didn't suddenly you start receiving 104 PV? You can never, because your LCR circuit is made, your means the LCR circuit of your instrument is made at resonance with a frequency which is being transmitted by a particular station. That's why you always match with that frequency. If it does not match, you cannot receive signals. Right? So quality factor is playing a very important role in this respect. Now, how to calculate quality factor of a given LCR circuit? So formula is, for calculating Q factor, you can say is defined as, I am giving you mathematical definition, as the ratio of potential difference across inductor or capacitor to the potential difference across a resistor. So Q factor is equal to potential difference across inductor or potential difference across capacitor divided by potential difference across resistor. So Q factor is equal to, I take potential difference across inductor over IR. I cancel because it's a series circuit. XR you can write it as omega L, and then you can write it as omega R. We have already got that 1 over square root LC into L over R, that is 1 over R square root over LC. This is the formula which you will use for calculating quality factor of the circuit. Now, if we plot a graph between current and frequency for two LCR circuits at resonance, I naught and the graph, one graph is like this, another graph is a little flattened. This has maximum current. So this circuit, graph number 1, quality factor is high, resistance is low. For second graph, Q is low, resistance is high. Now, to find the value of I, that RMS current, that you can easily calculate from on this graph. As we know, I is equal to I naught by root 2. I can write here also, I is equal to I naught by root 2. Draw perpendicular on x-axis. This is your resonant angular frequency. This is delta omega 1. This you can write it as delta omega 2. This is termed as upper side wind. This is termed as lower side wind. And this is termed as bandwidth. Actually, if you apply for any radio station or mobile company like Airtel and something else, government will always allocate you bandwidth. That's why each company has restricted to provide certain mobile numbers, because this is the bandwidth allocated for the particular vendor. Now you can also calculate quality factor by using this graph. The formula for calculating quality factor from this graph is equal to omega r 2 delta omega, where delta omega is bandwidth, right? Delta omega r is resonant frequency. So you can easily calculate quality factor by using this answer.